And now I'll show you how you make your own series. So I'm just gonna roll down here to the bottom of this list and hit insert. And that inserts an empty series. I can give it a name, new series. I usually give it a name that describes what it's going to do, as you can see in this list. Then I arrow over to steps, or I tap it with my finger and hit modify or return, and I can insert new steps here using my insert key on my keyboard. So we'll just make the three color chase if you want. Here we can add intensities. I can hit my column key to select the whole column, or if I have a mouse, I can right click here and use select column. Again, to select from the current position all the way down to the bottom of my list. Type 100, modify, and I get a full value on intensity. I arrow over to content. We'll do this the Nomad way with a mouse. Right click, select column. I hit modify, and I can see the content that I can choose from, color palettes. So I'm going to look at my color palettes, and I'm going to pick some new numbers. So 3, let's find a nice yellow. 4. And maybe magenta, 6. These numbers only mean those colors in this particular show file. I can import this series into another show file and record 3 completely different colors to 3, 4, and 6, and this series will still run. If I wanted to add more types of content, I could come over here and say, in this case, I want to have a gobo drop-in, so I'm going to pick beam palette number 2 in this show. And if I just put it in once, none of these other steps will ever tell that gobo to drop out. So it's a way of having this color chase run on top of that gobo automatically without having to get that information from somewhere else. If I want a gobo to chase with the colors, I just add more beam palettes into this column. I could do the same thing to ensure that the zoom is big. And all I did there was hit modify, and all the parameter names in the console are in this list as well. So I'm picking a raw zoom value and ensuring that the zoom is fully open when this effect runs, because it will open up that zoom on the first step. If I don't add any other values here, the zoom will open up and simply stay at that large setting until I change it by doing something else to that light. So this is how you can make a series. I'm going to run 3 colors with a gobo and in the big zoom and with intensity at full. One thing to remember here, one of the colors I picked was a yellow. If you're doing anything with video cameras, sometimes the color you pick could cause the cameras to want to iris in. So if you're causing your video engineer any kind of trouble, what you could do is on those particular colors say, I want the intensity to dip just a little bit to keep the color balanced with the rest of the look on stage. So now in this case, it'll be full when it's in dark blue, it'll be at 80% when it's in yellow, and it'll be full again at magenta. So this is a way you can tune a series to your particular needs at that particular moment. Then in the series list, here's that new series we built. It's showing it's got 4 steps, it's got 3 active steps and a background state. We'll let it run continuously, which is a perfectly good default mode for it. And then here I could change my timing if I wanted to have different default times when I first choose this series. So we're still working with the same effect playback. And I'll go into my series list and pick new series. And we'll see what happens. So here's our new series. And I'm looking at it and I'm wondering, why aren't there any gobos in it? And the reason for that is because I'm running it on wash lights, and wash lights don't have gobos. So that part of the series is simply ignored. What I can do now is I can say, actually, I'd like to have that running on my points. And now the points are running with the gobo and that color chase, running very fast, so we can slow it down, and in a full zoom. So have some fun with series. They are what you make them, and they're very useful, even if they're not just for the specific type of light that you think you originally built them for. It's best that you have a play with this to get used to how they work. But in a short period of time, you'll see just how flexible they can be.